Hey, how y'all doing out there? This is Radio DJ Apostle Rod Spurgeon presenting the IOPM, that is Infinite Order Prophetic Ministries, a.k.a. Daz Ministries, with fivefold ministry gift, Apostle Prophetess Darnetta Allen Skidmore. No need to prolong the time. Let's feel the power of God with Apostle Skidmore, shall we?
There's a little woman here, but she got the infinite power. Amen.
Come on, y'all gotta do better than that. Come on and bless the Lord. Hallelujah in the house. Come on and praise the Lord. See, y'all, I can't hold my view. Y'all gotta understand my position. I've been a praise and worship leader. You know, you gotta shift some atmosphere. Amen. Come on, somebody. Come on and bless them. I ain't come to preach tonight, but I came to deliver an impartation tonight that you will be encouraged on tonight. Come on, high five your neighbor and say, I will be encouraged. Hallelujah. Okay, y'all remember how Walmart and Kmart used to have layaway?
read this one. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power, exousia, y'all, that worketh in us. Ephesians 3:20. Then if we go back here, I'm going to go to a doxology from Jude. Oh, Lord, Jude, the first chapter, the only chapter, 24 verse, it says, now to him who is able to keep you without stumbling or slipping,
yes, Lord,
or falling,
yes,
and to present you unblemished, yes, blameless, and faultless. Come on here. Before the presence of his glory in triumph, joy, and exaltation. First we're talking about strength, being strong. Now you're going to have some glory after this.
That's
tomorrow.
Yes.
So my question to you is, what are you asking him for?
Uh-huh.
What are you thinking? And what are you expecting?
Uh-huh.
You got to first ask him for something.
Uh-huh.
But what's going on in your mind while you're asking him?
Uh-huh.
Because if something else is going on in your mind, you just lost what you were asking him for.
Uh-huh.
Glory to God. Uh-huh. Hallelujah. Now, if you're in a place, this is what God gave me. I think about praise as you counting it joy. For all I have asked for, so that asking is just an action for the unction. So I'm expecting God to move something out of my way. So it reminded me of my boys, y'all. Come on here. Paul and Silas. All right, do y'all realize they were already ready for what was ahead? The reason why the enemy come and sneak you is because you wasn't prepared for what was ahead. So this is what got me right here. The Bible says, Acts 16:25, at the midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sing praises unto God. And the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison was shaken. And immediately, all the doors were open, and everyone's bands were loose. Okay, this is where God brought me to, midnight. When you're in your anyhow place, you're in your midnight. But in your anyhow place, you got to begin to pray. That is the time you have to begin to press like never before. Okay, Holy Ghost. You know those times when there's choir rehearsal at 6 o'clock? And nobody shows up till 6:30. Or we have those who will march in and say, oh, I had to go do this. And it wasn't even important. It could have waited. The Lord is talking about accountability and consistency in this hour. See, what I find that hinders the praise, and I served in the Baptist church choir on the soprano side, amen. And I used to hear a lot of stuff, y'all. Amen. And one thing that I understood is that a lot of the time you hear the bickering and the complaining, it's always against what's right.
Always.
What's supposed to be this way. You got so many opinions. And the Lord wants to shift that, because what happens with the opinions is it spills over in the praise.
Yeah.
You will have Sister So-and-so with her eyeglasses on her eyes because she's mad at what happened at rehearsal. Because we have not let go what happened then, because God wants to do something now. You know, even when you're having to press, pressing could be a way down situation. Why? Because we're so busy carrying the weight. I can't worship God with everything on my shoulders. If I had a fuss at home or a disappointment on the job, I got some bad news in the mail or whatever, what have you, why can't you praise your way through it? Okay, thank you, Holy Ghost. Lord, you're giving me another one. If all the lights was turned out in the church, if we turn the lights off and your charge was to get up and stand up, and one voice at the corner of the door said, oh, over here. All of us in here will hear that voice, right? But guess what we all going to do when we get up? It will be really dark in here. We're going to all get up, and we're going to first use our hands because we need to feel our way. Or we're going to grab on Sister So-and-so because we know we're going to walk out together. Well, God will put you in a position called the midnight hour. That's the darkness of the soul. There's a season each and every one of us go through. You're going to go through your season when nothing makes sense. And Lord talked about rejection, frustration. I'm sick and tired. I wish they'd stop takes when God is trying to pull you out, it's almost like being in a hole. If I'm in a hole and a rope is there for me to climb, yes, you will have to use your muscles. Yes, you're going to have to put your feet up and try to climb up. But some of us won't lift our muscles because we're going to complain. My back, my neck and my back, my feet, my head. We won't find reasons and excuses. It's time out for excuses. Because in the new level, the new remnant, God was speaking about the remnant. In the remnant that he sent here. And suddenly there was a great earthquake so that the foundation of the prison was shaken. And immediately, all the doors were open. And everyone's hands, bands, were loose. Okay, this is where God brought me to, midnight. When you're in your anyhow place, you're in your midnight. But in your anyhow place, you got to begin to pray. That is the time you have to begin to press like never before. Okay, Holy Ghost. You know those times when there's choir rehearsal at 6 o'clock and nobody shows up till 6:30? Or we have those who will march in and say, oh, I had to go do this. And it wasn't even important. It could have waited. The Lord is talking about accountability and consistency in this hour. See, what I find that hinders the praise. And I served in the Baptist church choir. I'm on the soprano side, amen. And I used to hear a lot of stuff, y'all. Amen. And one thing that I understood is that a lot of the time you hear the bickering and the complaining, it's always against what's right. What's supposed to be this way. You got so many opinions. And the Lord wants to shift that, because what happens with the opinions is it spills over in the praise. You will have Sister So-and-so with her eyeglasses on her eyes because she mad at what happened at rehearsal. Because we have not let go of what happened then, because God wants to do something now. You know, even when you're having to press, pressing could be a way down situation. Why? Because we're so busy carrying the weight. I can't worship God with everything on my shoulders. If I had a fuss at home or a disappointment on the job, I got some bad news in the mail or whatever, what have you. Why can't you praise your way through it? Okay, thank you, Holy Ghost. Lord, you're giving me another one. If all the lights was turned out in the church, if we turn the lights off, and your charge was to get up and stand up, and one voice at the corner of the door said, oh, over here. All of us in here will hear that voice, right? But guess what we all going to do when we get up? It will be really dark in here. We're going to all get up, and we're going to first use our hands because we need to feel our way. Or we're going to grab on Sister So-and-so because we know we're going to walk out together. Well, God will put you in a position called the midnight hour. That's the darkness of the soul. There's a season each and every one of us go through. You're going to go through your season when nothing makes sense. And Lord talked about rejection, frustration. I'm sick and tired. I wish they'd stop calling me. Come on here. We all had them. Oh, I need to take off from work. I'm sick. You know being sick, you better repent. Oh, Lord, in the name of Jesus. You know, there's a time when we do go through those times. But my question to you is, in your anyhow time, the enemy comes to steal your negativity so he can build it up even stronger against you. And that wall begins to hinder you from what God has ahead of you. So my question here is, why is it we stay in that place when God is trying to pull you out? It's almost like being in a hole. If I'm in a hole and a rope is there for me to climb, yes, you will have to use your muscles. Yes, you're going to have to put your feet up and try to climb up. But some of us won't lift our muscles because we're going to complain. My back, my neck and my back, my feet, my head. We won't find reasons and excuses. It's time out for excuses. Because in the new level, the new remnant, God was speaking about the remnant. In the remnant that he sent here, it's for us to engage in new levels of worship. For us to begin to receive at a different level. Everything can happen the same way it used to.
Come on.
Because some of your blessings are tied up because you have not released the old stuff. You see? Thank you. Oh, my God. See, we have to begin to be free in God. There's a liberation present. So, do you not know that those boys was in prison? And all of a sudden, there was a change begin to happen because of all they had deposited. What are you depositing in your accounts? Okay. Thank you, Holy Ghost. You got me here. Amen. Okay. So if I went to the bank And everybody looked at you, okay. But by the end of the year, how's your account going? Oh, girl, they closed it. Why did they close it? Because I didn't put anything in there. Why is it in the negative? Or why did they close it? God is saying you have to learn how to, just like you can manage your money. Boy, you can manage money. You will watch every penny that come out of your wallet. But what's happening now then when God wants something more from you and you make excuses for what God wants from you? Now, I love the praise. I love the praise. Yes, I do. But I am more of a worshiper. I am. I'm Sam. I am. Hallelujah. Now, pardon me if I don't pronounce this word right, because if I had to use one Greek word, I better use the other one too. Worship. Proskuneo. Proskuneo? Help me, Pastor. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. This means giving reverence to adore. Now, worship brought me to when you met the love of your life. Way back in the gap. From the country, y'all. I remember that now. You couldn't eat or sleep. You stayed on the phone after hours. Ran mom and dad's phone bill up. Y'all get the picture, right? You build a relationship with somebody. Husband and wife build a relationship. If he look a certain way, she gonna know something wrong, baby. What's wrong? You build a relationship. So you know him well. He knows you well. Now, what about the relationship with God? He made you. And a lot of us say, oh, the Lord know my heart. For real? Are you talking to him? For real. Are you giving him his time? You know, the prophet's gotta laugh at me sometimes because the Lord gets me up at 3 a.m. to pray. Do you think I feel like it? Really, flesh, you know. But what happens is, in your prayer time, you get more intimate with God. Yes. Because there he can put a deposit in you. That's something God will awaken you in your worship. Yes. Now, as the deer panted by the waters, Psalms 48, that's a thirsty place. You ever been so tired? I always pray for the pastors because I know they pour out so much. Leaders in general have to pray for them because they pour out so much. But I heard a pastor say, I prefer to be around anointed people because I get my strength back. But I get the point because what happens is if I'm down and out, I can call on a prophet. I can call on a few people and just begin to talk. You didn't got to say anything. Before you know it, you're back. You're back up. So when you have a relationship with God, God begins to pour into you. And guess what? You know what's so strange about it? You will be activated and not operating. He would wake you up. He would give you sermons, titles, books, all this kind of stuff. Come up with these little things. You don't know what's going on. And the Lord begins to say, I'm going to move in a level of revelation so the people will understand what I'm trying to teach them. So if you are walking in a new level of worship, then your whole attitude will change. I'm talking about after the praise, after the breakthrough, after I receive my release. Yes. The Lord wants to release. Yes. But you got to also know that the devil also wants some stuff from you. That's why he comes in to distract you. Yes. That's why he comes in to give you all these problems. Some of us get chest pain, boy. Stress that hits your real hard. Oh, my chest. Oh, my head. Really? We have to change our position. Some of us will worship him in surrender position. Some of us will bow our head in worship. Some of us will kneel down in worship. But nobody wants to get on their face. I wonder why. Jesus. You know what I used to say way back then before I understood all this stuff? Can I keep it real? Why did he be down there so long? That gotta hurt. Because I wasn't there yet. That's what my understanding was. But when it happened to me, I felt like Velcro stuck to the floor. I couldn't get up. I really thought it was a joke, for real. But then the Lord began to do some great things in me, and it really brought me to a place where my eyes began to see like never before. There are so many gifts lying dormant in the body of Christ that need to be accessed. Yes. Why even have a key if you on the door with it.
Come on.
Oh my. God wants us to come up higher, come up hither. Arise. I want to go to the new place. I want to go to a place where I can reach and receive from God. So therefore, everything else in your life will light up. You will no longer, because I call my God, thank you, Holy Ghost. The dry place is my place when I need him. I need the oh, I need. Come on. Every hour. Don't you need him every hour?
Yeah.
Don't you need him to shake you and mold you and make you? Don't you need him to lift you up when you're feeling down? Don't you need him to begin to wrap his arms around you? You know that song, I heard it all day. Wrap me in your arms.
Yes.
Wrap me in your arms.
Yes.
Wrap me in your arms. You know, can you just feel it? Wrap me in your arms. Wrap me in your arms. Wrap me in your arms. Hallelujah. When God began to wrap you in his arms, you are his child. He is the Father. There's nothing like being wrapped in the Father's arms. That means all your trouble, all your trials, all your tests, they cannot hold you. They cannot determine your destiny. God has a destiny plan for each and every one of you. But will you press in? Will you press in? Will you press in? Grandmama, daddy, phone, fill up. Y'all get the picture, right? You build a relationship with somebody. Husband and wife build a relationship. If he look a certain way, she gonna know something wrong, baby. What's wrong? You build a relationship, so you know him well. He knows you well. Now, what about the relationship with God? He made you, and a lot of us say, "Oh, the Lord know my heart." For real? Are you talking to him?
For real?
Are you giving him his time? You know, the prophets gotta laugh at me sometimes because. The Lord gets me up at 3 in the morning to pray. Do you think I feel like it? Really? Flesh, you know. But what happens is, in your prayer time, you get more intimate with God.
Yes.
Because there he can put a deposit in you. There's something God will awaken you in your worship.
Yes.
Now, as the deer panted by the waters, Psalms 48, that's a thirsty place. You ever been so tired? I always pay, pray for the pastors because I know they pour out so much. Leaders in general have to pray for them because they pour out so much. But I heard a pastor say, I prefer to be around anointed people because I get my strength back. But I get the point because what happens is if I'm down and out, I can call on prophet. I can call on a few people and just begin to talk. You didn't gotta say anything. Before you know it, you're back. You're back up. So when you have a relationship with God, God begins to pour into you. And guess what? You know what's so strange about it? You will be activated and not operating. He would wake you up. He would give you sermons, titles, books, all this kind of stuff. Come up with these little things. You don't know what's going on. And the Lord begins to say, I'm going to move in a level of revelation so the people will understand what I'm trying to teach them. So if you are walking in a new level of worship, then your whole attitude will change. I'm talking about after the praise, after the breakthrough, after I receive my release.
Yes.
The Lord wants to release.
Yes.
But you got to also know that the devil also wants some stuff from you. That's why he comes in to distract you.
Yes.
That's why he comes in to give you all these problems. Some of us get chest pain, boy. Stress that hits you real hard. Oh, my chest. Oh, my head. Really? We have to change our position. Some of us will worship him in surrender position. Some of us will bow our head in worship. Some of us will kneel down in worship. But nobody wants to get on their face. I wonder why. Jesus. You know what I used to say way back then before I understood all this stuff? Can I keep it real? Why did he be down there so long? That gotta hurt. Because I wasn't there yet. That's what my understanding was. But when it happened to me, I felt like Velcro stuck to the floor. I couldn't get up. I really thought it was a joke, for real. But then the Lord began to do some great things in me, and it really brought me to a place where my eyes began to see like never before. There's so many gifts lying to be accessed.
Yes.
Why even have a key if you can't open the door with it?
Come on.
God wants us to come up higher, come up hither. Arise. I want to go to the new place. I want to go to a place where I can reach and receive from God. So therefore, everything else in your life will light up. You will no longer, because I call, oh my God, thank you, Holy Ghost. The dry place is my place when I need him. I need the all I need. Come on. Every hour. Don't you need him every hour?
Yeah.
Don't you need him to shake you and mold you and make you? Don't you need him to lift you up when you're feeling down? Don't you need him to begin to wrap his arms around you? You know that song, I heard it all day. Wrap me in your arms.
Yes.
Wrap me in your arms.
Yes.
Wrap me in your arms. You know, can you just feel it? Wrap me in your arms. Wrap me in your arms. Wrap me in your arms. Hallelujah.
Yes.
When God began to wrap you in his arms, you are his child. He is the Father. There's nothing like being wrapped in the Father's arm. That means all your trouble, all your trials, all your tests, they cannot hold you. They cannot determine your destiny. God has a destiny plan for each and every one of you. But will you press in? Will you press in? Will you press in? It's time out for all the planned church in this hour. God said you got to learn how to activate that voice you have. You got the power in you. Glory to God. It's time to pull down.
I get up there and rehearse it, I'm singing it.
And he tried to catch the note, but he couldn't get it. Then I started feeling a certain way. You know, he just don't like the way I sound. Oh, well. But what I learned was, it wasn't for my voice. That song wasn't for me. But I wanted to sing it, too, real bad. And you'll find people who will, you know, Minister Renita, I like that song. Can you work with me with it? And you'll start working, and that's not, baby, that's not you. But you know what happens? Everybody don't want to know the truth. What happens is we get up on Sunday, get in front of the people, start singing, and nobody start clapping or nothing, because y'all, like, I gotta remind y'all from the Baptist church, okay? And I don't get no clapping, and I'm like looking around like,
it's all right, baby.
Say, baby. You know, I remember when the Lord began to deal with my heart, and he really began to elevate me, and I didn't know what happened. There was a song that I was singing, and the Holy Spirit, I mean, it hit me. That was my first experience. And my arms went like a shock. And everybody was looking at me crazy, and I didn't know what happened. And my mom didn't want nobody to touch me. Leave alone. So the Holy Spirit didn't call God anymore. And it just let me finish shouting, and I'm going to sit down. And still sitting down and trying to figure it out. And when the Lord begins to do stuff like that, and it comes through your singing, you better know everybody in the choir won't catch the fire. But what we do, y'all know we do it, don't play. We look at it, we look, we stand. Look at Sister So-and-so, she going through something. you know a husband never let tweak a girl. Oh no, and I like it was up. But y'all, that's the type of place I came out of, you know. And it's not a negative, it's we learn, yeah, we learn. And we, you know, if you don't know, you don't grow, amen. So we have to get out of that mindset. When somebody shout, let them go ahead, babe. Make a circle around them, shoot, let them go. Make sure she fall comfortable. Hallelujah. But I bless the Lord because one thing I know is as we are yielded, God will do a great work in us. He will. He will. He will. I have not, I'm telling you, that I believe after tonight, there's going to be a great transition because sometimes if we're not, everybody here wanted to be here. You were going to be here before you knew you were going to be here. But one thing God has already done is he's worked whatever it is out. Because one thing I know about conferences for a mass choir in a Baptist church is an acceleration happens. It's needed. It's needed. Because I like to say, like my old pastor used to say, it makes the atmosphere so much easier and conducive for God to move. You know, we don't have to depend. You don't need, and I always say this, you don't need a certain song to shift an atmosphere. Because at the cross, baby, we'll shift the atmosphere. It really would. It really would. And a lot of times we get caught up in what we hear, contemporary. Either or. It's not even a song, it's what's in the heart. Because what are you, who are you singing to? Are you singing because my throat was sore last night? As it comes from your heart, allow the Lord to do the rest. Because all you have to do is stay together, pray together. Pray together. Pray like never before. Because it's through your prayers. Everybody needs prayer. Everybody. Hallelujah. Come on, bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, come on.
Hey man, now wasn't that a move of God? Boy, I tell you, I got my miracle. This is IOPM once again, Infinite Order Prophetic Ministries, and I'm your DJ, Apostle Spurgeon. What you just experienced was the Honorable Apostle Prophetess Darnetta Allen Skidmore. If you'd like to pay your tithe, sow a seed, or just have a prayer request, you can do so by sending such to the following. IOPM, that's Infinite Order Prophetic Ministries, P.O. Box 258, Paincourtville, Louisiana, 70391. Once again, that's IOPM, P.O. Box 258, Paincourtville, Louisiana, 70391. Her email address is DarnettaS@gmail.com, and her ministry website is DazMinistries.org. Until next time, this is Daz Ministries with IOPM, and in the words of Apostle Skidmore, glory to the Master.